What's up, everybody? Exul's Extreme here, and today we're going to be showing off the awesome capabilities of the F-22 Raptor in Microsoft Flight Simulator. This is the top mock version, and what we're going to do is we're going to do the airshow maneuvers that are specifically detailed on pages 46 through 50 in the manual. And of course, I will leave a link to the manual in the description of this video so you can check it out. And we're going to go through and try out all the maneuvers. And so let's get this bird off the ground first off and see what we can do here. Let's see. Parking brake off. There's some power there, Captain. Mine pulls to the right a little bit, so I gotta watch it. There we go. Take off. Hold that landing gear. It's a quick landing gear. Alright, so the Cobra is the first one on the list. And so to do the Cobra, it says we need to be going under 250 knots. And you know, let's turn back around and we'll come. I'm actually recording this too as well with the replay thing, so it'd be cool to watch it from the ground and see how well we do as far as an air show performance goes. So we will turn the Raptor back around. How's that for a turn? Alright, so let's get centered over the runway like you would at an air show, because that's basically, this is Travis Air Force Base, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that. And when they do have the air show, they have it lined up along this runway, and then they have the fence and stuff, so right behind that taxiway next to the runway. So the planes come by right here, like so. And in this, it says documented you should be above 500 altitude. So we want to just be up just a little bit more. And we want to be at 250 or below and then go full throttle. So we'll get to 240, hit full throttle, and pull back on the stick, and then pull, immediately go forward. And that's your Cobra. And actually, you can do a little bit better one if you use your trim, your elevator trim. So right now you can see it's in the middle. If we get 250, we kind of do it at around 230 and we pull down the trim like so, and really get a crazy one and let off on the gas and then go full throttle again. It'll kind of do a little stall and bring you back down into the Cobra. And you can work at it and you can probably do a way better one than the one we just did, but still, yeah, it's pretty cool. So next is the power loop. So let's get lined back up with the runway here. Power loop. The power loop, you can do it at the same altitude, like 500, but I think it suggests a little bit more than 1500. Right, so looping back around. The power loop. You want to be going 300 to 330. So we'll stay right in this here and we'll gain a little bit of altitude. And here we go. And right when we get to 330, we'll pull up and just keep on pulling. Our elevator was already all the way up, so I didn't really notice that. Doesn't really matter that much, and then once we get level with the ground, we'll thrust out of it, and there you go, the power loop. So it flows, pulls the power loop, awesome, of course. Alright, next is the J-turn. And the J-turn, we want to be going at least 2,500 altitude, which seems a little high, because I've seen them do it. When they say at the air show, it's a little bit different, the air show, from what it's on here. And it says you want to be going from between 100 and 180 knots. And so once again, we'll get turned around again and come back at our runway. Sort of like a little hammerhead here. Oop. A little low, pull up. All right, so here's the runway again. And for the J-turn, the way they do it at the air show, he comes and he does a crazy freaking pull, like right here. Whoops, I was going too fast. And then he goes straight up. And then usually goes into like a power loop or something like that. Just because the F-22 can. And we'll come back at it and do that again, because that wasn't very good, but... one thing we do need to keep an eye on is our fuel, because we didn't want to be overweight, so we're only about 50% weight. So let's go and add a little bit more in to make it 50%. Don't want to run out of fuel, because you're using the afterburner a lot to do a lot of these moves. So, all right. So once again, we'll come back and try the J turn. I was going way too fast. I don't know what I was thinking. I was like at 500 and like, oh, I think I'll bank into the J turn. It's like, yeah, no, you need to be going 100. Basically, almost need to be at a stall. It's not really the way they do it at the air show, though. At least every time I've seen them say, this is the J turn. Alright, so slow down here. I know when Cabo did the one over last year, I was there all 3 days, so I saw the J-turn quite a few times, plus he did the practice too, I was there for that. He would come over the runway like so, and he would be actually a little bit lower. And then he'd probably be going, I'd say about 200 to 210, so it was pretty slow. He came in, definitely wasn't 100 though, 100's like stall, and then once he got over to a certain point, he just bank into the thing like this, dip out over the field, and go straight vertical. And like at first it seems like the jet's gonna stall, and all of a sudden it just goes boom, straight up like that. And that's what they say is the J turn. So I don't know what they have labeled in here. To me looks like a hammerhead. So I don't know. And then from there you can do whatever you want to finish off the maneuver. There's everything with the Raptor, it's a series of tricks. Alright, so the pedal turn. The pedal turn is basically the falling leaf. It's kind of like a straight vertical thrust, straight vertical pull up Cobra. Into vertical thrust, doing some twists, into a power loop, and then of course the falling leaf maneuver down. So we'll come back around, get over the crowd again. It's nice with the Raptor because you can turn on a dime and do that little hammerhead, which is basically what they kind of said the J turn was, but. Alright, so for the pedal turn, let's see, aspiring speed of 250 to 300, and it says we want to be at 4,000 altitude. Now you can be lower because you're going to go up, so you're going to thrust all the way up. So let's slow down just a little bit. We can use our air brake to get down to 300. So about 300, and then hit it and pull directly up. Hold that and then spin around. Oh, not really level. Well, that happens. We'll come back at it and try it again. You can see how it would do it, and then from here you just start doing the alright, let's come back at it. Sorry about that. It's honestly kind of easier to do this in the cockpit, but then you wouldn't really be able to see the maneuver. So I probably will go back and do a stream where I do them all in the cockpit too. The interesting one in the cockpit is the high alpha. That one's hard to do because you're so banked into it. So, whoops, I'm fast now. Dang it. Lose some of that speed. Just take your tanks off too if you don't like them. I kind of gave up. I was taking them off every time and then I was like, eh, whatever. Alright, so let's see if we can do this right. So, like I said, between 250 and 300. And then we'll pull directly up. And, come on, stay over the runway. What am I doing here? Alright, there we go. And then full thrust. Let's go pull directly up. And then we'll do our twists. Normally it does two of them. Then we're still kind of going up. And then we go into our power loop, basically. And then from there, you want to just hit your rudder. And you'll start rotating around. As you can see. And you're falling, and so that's the falling leaf. You can see your airspeed's at zero. And then when you want to come out of it, just go ahead and give her full thrust and thrust out of it. That would have been a nice crowd pleaser, because you were right over the crowd when you ended up. So that's what the pedal turn is in page 48 of the manual. Alright, the slow speed pass, so we'll come back at the runway and do the slow speed pass. Bank around here. It's weird in this view, like when you do the cockpit a lot, this is actually kind of a little tougher. Because you can't see the turn or anything, you know? Alright, so to get in the high alpha, basically you just reduce your speed. And you'd want your trim to the up position. And once you get over the runway, go ahead and pull back. And then start giving her full thrust. And there's kind of a happy medium between the thrust, and then that's just all in your thrust, and you keep her from wobbling back on the stick. And with the F-22, you got to do a lot of work to keep it a perfect high alpha, basically. But man, you can do spectacular high alphas with this jet, as you can see. There's the vent flaps opened up. So cool when that happens. They're so stealthy. So you just keep it right over the runway and yeah, keep the throttle control, and you gotta work at it, that's for sure. It ain't like the F-35. The F-35 is really easy to do the high alpha in this game. It'll just sit there, you don't even have to do anything. The F-22 is a little more work, but does some beautiful high alpha, that's for sure. So you can see our airspeed's not really even registering, it's so low. Slow speed pass. And then when you want to come out of it, just go full thrust and then put your trim up to the middle and actually push forward, and that'll bring you out of it like so. And that was the high alpha. Alright, so the loaded roll is It's basically a roll, but they call it loaded because you kind of do a little dip into it with the F-22. It's like a roller coaster sort of tail slide, dip into it, if you do it right. It's kind of hard to do, actually. It says that the tail slide's the hardest one to do, but the tail slide's not that hard to do. Put some more fuel in this thing here. Alright, hold on one sec. Stay 50, okay, and then the loaded roll. So, at 1,000 feet, we want to be going about 200 when we do this. So let's pick up a little bit of speed. And then we're going to go up and down into it and then pull over. And it does that little tail kick like that. And I think that's why they call it the loaded roll. I'm not really sure, but it is pretty cool the way it works. So it's like a little roller coaster. You go up and down into it and then pull over and it does that little kick. And so yeah, the loaded roll, and we'll come back and do the tail slide here. The tail slide, the way they have it, is it's basically a stall. You come up, slide into it, do the stall, and then come out of it. Whereas my versions of the tail slides more like the thrust version, where you go something like this, full throttle, and then come into it like that, and go boom. So the tail slides around. Okay, so come back over the runway here. Pull up and go straight up. Until it starts falling backwards, like so. That's what their version of the tail slide is in this booklet, so. Which would look pretty cool, that's for sure, in front of the crowd. And that's it. That's all the maneuvers that they have in this booklet. Of course, there's all the normal maneuvers that you would do, like the inverted pass and the high-speed pass and all that, so. And your weapons bay pass, so you'd come, you know, by and open up the weapons bay. And you'd have, if you do have other jets, like the older jets, the Warbirds, then you would do all your honorary passes and all those type of things, and your heritage flights, and, yep. Yeah, the F-22 is a pretty amazing jet, so. But that was page 46 through 50 in the booklet, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I will leave the link to the description for to purchase this jet, as well as to download the manual, so you can check it out and see if you want to do some airshow maneuvers. You're down. hard landing. Oh, by the way, that's the one thing about this jet. It's hard to land, especially in third person. If you go into the cockpit, it's a lot easier. So I probably could have nailed that if I actually went in the cockpit, but yeah. So, and there we go. Touchdown, successful execution of the air show maneuvers using the F-22 Raptor from Top Mock Studio. And I will show the replay after this as well, but I won't have any commentary on it. So we'll just have a list of what the moves are. And from there, that's all we got. So anyways, thanks for checking this out. And of course, peace out and stick around for the crowd view of the air show.